Good morning to all. So we have completed last class. Yeah, we completed last time. Most of you remember that equation of motion of a particle moving under the influence of a central force. So today, what we are going to, as I mentioned last time, we have ended with, everybody remember this equation last time, right? You remember this? What is the final equation that we got at this? So you have to remember this equation. This is a very useful equation. Equation of motion. Okay. Equation motion of particle under moving under the influence of central force. Very, very important question that we discussed last time. And hope today we are going to discuss the K+ class. I mean, I can see only few members. I don't know why they are not joining. So if I don't see the members next time, I'm not going to take an online class. So I would expect more in online than offline. I can see 20 members. So online also 20 members. It doesn't make sense, right? What is the problem? But you have to join, right? Just 1 hour here and then join there. I mean, if you have any problem, let me know. So I don't know. I mean, I cannot repeat same thing there. I've just started there basics of vectors. Then whenever I get a time, I'll just go through the revision. Basically, I'm revising things over there. Okay. I'm giving exam. Today will be exam actually in the college, Stokes theorem and Gauss theorem. So I'm keeping that exam today. I hope that you prepared well. Okay. So coming to the, it's a very, very important question. K+ laws of planetary motion. So what are the K+ laws? You all know that K+ laws play a very important role in planetary or solar system, right? So most of you remember in the intermediate Kepler's, what the contribution of the Kepler, okay? So he's a really wonderful, he's a really great scientist. He contributed to the science a lot, and his principles helps to understand the planetary system. So what is the first law? So you have title should be Kepler's laws of planetary motion. Okay. And the first law, every planet revolve around the sun in an elliptical orbit with the sun at one of the foci. Basically, it's a kind of like this. Okay. Elliptical orbit should be like this. And one foci should be here, the other foci should be here. If the planet is here, so the foci is here, okay, A and B. So every planet, basically, it revolves around the elliptical orbit. It revolves around the elliptical orbit, okay, with the sun situated at one of the foci. Means it could be here, it could be here. So it always revolve around the elliptical orbit. So you have to remember that the first law of the first law of the Kepler is every planet how they revolve in a elliptical orbit. What happened? Sun should be one of the person. So let us repeat, and you have to revise in your brain. Every planet revolve around the sun, okay, in elliptical orbit with the sun situated one of the foci. That is called first law of K केपलर, केपलर लॉ, प्लैनेटरी मोशन, फर्स्ट लॉ। सेकंड लॉ, व्हाट इज द सेकंड लॉ? दिस इज ऑल्सो मस्ट रिमेंबर दैट व्हेन यू आर इन इंटरमीडिएट, द रेडियस ऑफ द वेक्टर, द रेडियस ऑफ द वेक्टर जॉइनिंग, लेट अस से दिस इज आवर यू नो, सो ऑब्टेन दैट, सो हियर एस वन एस टू, the radius, let us say this and this, the radius vector joining the planet and sun. Here is the sun, here is the planet. Okay, so what happened? So here is sun, is the planet is here. The radius vector is this, the radius vector joining planet and sun sweeps. What is this sweeps? This cover. What is that? Cover. And what the cover chest sweeps equal areas in equal interval of time. That is called aerial velocity is constant. Sir, so what is that? I didn't understand, sir. Yes, let me give again. The radius, suppose, beta, what I'm trying to tell, if this area must be equal to this area, sir, it doesn't make sense how it be. It makes sense, beta. I'm saying that the radius, even if you consider this and this, this and this, all should be same. Even if I say this one also same, but only this area, whatever the time from here to here that sweeps out same area, the time from here to here. Okay, the radius vector. The radius vector joining, so this definitely radius vector joined between the planet and sun. Okay, the radius vector joining planet and sun sweeps out, cover out equal areas in a equal interval of time. That is called aerial velocity is constant. Is the rate of change of where area should be constant. Okay. dAy dt is equals to constant. Is it clear? Any doubts?
Sir, aerial velocity ante the velocity neera sir.
I'm sorry.
Aerial velocity.
Aerial velocity.
Ante enti sir?
Aerial velocity, the area changing with respect to time, that is called aerial velocity.
Okay sir.
If the area changing with respect to time, we call it as a aerial velocity. Is it okay? Yes.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Understand. Right.
So, moving into third law. Third law, most of you remember that the square of the time period, the square of the time period is whatever the, you know, is directly proportional to the, directly proportional to the cube of the semi-major axis of the ellipse. Suppose, as I mentioned before, okay, the time, this is your ellipse. The square of the time period of the planet. Suppose, so this is the, you know, 2 plus S1 and S2. Okay. And you know that, you know, this is the log A. We call it as a, this is equal to 2A. And this is equal to 2B. Right? You might have studied in the ellipse in the mathematics. So from here to here, it should be A. Okay, from here to here is B. The total is 2B, but here to here is B. So now he's saying that the square of the time period of the planet directly proportional to the cube of the semi-major axis. And then whatever the time takes to complete one revolution, one cycle, that must be equal to the cube of the semi-major axis. అంటే ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడ ఉన్నటువంటి ఏకి
క్యూబ్ ఈక్వల్ అవుతుంది అంటే టి స్క్వేర్ ఇస్ డైరెక్ట్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ టు ది ఏ క్యూబ్ దిస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ థర్డ్ లా యు షుడ్ రిమెంబర్ దట్ స్క్వేర్ ఆఫ్ ది టైం పీరియడ్ ఆఫ్ ది ప్లానెట్ అంటే ప్లానెట్ ఎలాగో రివాల్వ్ అవుతుంది కదా ఎలక్ట్రికల్ వేలో అప్పుడు దానికి టైం అంటే ఒక ఒక కంప్లీట్ సైకిల్ చేయడానికి పట్టిన టైం టి అయితే దాని స్క్వేర్ అనేది డైరెక్ట్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ టు ది ఇక్కడికి వెళ్ళి ఇక్కడికి ఉన్నటువంటి ఆ రేడియస్ అంటే ఒకవేళ సెమీ మేజర్ యాక్సిస్ అంటారు దీన్ని ఇదేమో మైనర్ యాక్సిస్ ని బి అంటారు సో అది ఏ క్యూబ్ కి డైరెక్ట్ ప్రపోర్షనల్ గా ఉంటుంది దీన్నే మనము వాట్ డు యు కాల్ ఇట్ థర్డ్ లా ఓకే ఇస్ ఇట్ క్లియర్ Yes, students. Any doubts?
No, sir.
So that let me repeat again. The first law is let us close your eyes. Don't memorize it, but recall it. Whatever we discussed. The first law is basically, every planet revolve around the sun in elliptical orbit. The sun situated about the foci. That's the first law. Second law is radius vector joining planet and sun sweeps equal area in equal interval of time. That is called area velocity is constant. Third, the square of the time period of the planet is directly proportional to the cube of the semi-major axis of the ellipse. It's called third law. Okay, can I go for next slide? Yes, so this they will ask a 4 marks question. Okay. So now the four long answer question again. So what I'm going to do. So here, long answer question. Equation of motion of planet under inverse square law. What is this? So I did not write again equations in the text file. Then I did not. So I just took a image file. It's okay, but when I get a time, I'll do that. So you have to remember the title is equation of motion of planet under inverse square's law. What is the square inverse square's law? We know that gmm by r square. This is a inverse square law, gravitational inverse square law, Newton gravitational law. So we have to get the equation of motion when you have the when you use the inverse square law. Okay, so we're gonna complete that, then after that first law. Okay, so did you copy this one? So the equation that we ended last time is equation of motion of particle moving under the influence of central forces. So do you remember this equation we have completed last time? Right. So, did you remember this equation? Whatever we ended last time, equation of motion. This is equation number one. Let's say. Okay. So, moving into the. So here I just keep the side to help you. Oh, not this one. I guess this is the wrong file. I guess is it? Oh, something wrong file. I have kept it. There's one more file. Now this one. No, there's another one. Let me stop and get that file back. It should be. Yeah, this one. Yeah, I can see this file.
before when I can do it, I'll make it duplicate. So I'll keep it this, I'll remove it and go. Right. Right. So, are you able to see the file?
No, sir.
Yes or no? Are you able to see the file? Yes?
Sir, zoom. Zoom in.
Now I did, right? Can you able to see the file?
కొంచెం జూమ్ చేయండి సార్, కనబడట్లేదు సరిగా.
మనం జూమ్ చేసుకోవచ్చు బ్రో.
ఐ కెన్ డు ఇట్ ఆన్ ద రైట్ సైడ్, దేర్ ఇస్ ఏ స్పేస్ ఫర్ అస్ రైట్. జూమ్ అది అంతకన్నా ఎక్కువ కాదు. వాట్ ఐ కెన్ డు ఇట్ ఆన్ ద రైట్ సైడ్. సో ద ప్రీవియస్ ఈక్వేషన్ యు రిమెంబర్ రైట్, వాట్ వాస్ ద యాక్చువల్ ప్రీవియస్ ఈక్వేషన్? d స్క్వేర్
ప్రొపోర్షనల్ టు gmm బై r స్క్వేర్
dt స్క్వేర్ d theta స్క్వేర్ రైట్.
Okay, okay.
Plus U is equal to, tell me, we got it right before. Plus minus FR by, right, H square. Did you remember that previously we got it this one last class, if you remember that, what we got to tell me, FR by H square. This was actually final equation, right? Okay, so then where F is what actually we have done that last time, is equal to FR by M, right? So this was done before. Okay. Here R is the distance between the sun and planet. In this case, what is R? It is a distance between the, it is a distance between the sun and planet. So if according to the gravitational law, minus gm by r square. Okay. So what is this r here? Here you are saying that capital M is the mass of the sun. Oh, no, here if you say small m is the mass of the planet, suppose Earth, this is like a planet. This is the mass of the sun. Okay. So from here, what I can write it is F by M equals to G M by R square. So this is, let us say, equation number 2. Okay. So what should I do here? I can substitute. So you can see here, force acting on a planet for unit mass is FR. So what I am saying here, you can say same like FR this one, or you can say this is small f again, and this capital F is equal to small f by M. So FR is given. You substitute this, substitute in one equation where you have the FR. Okay. What is going to be telling me? D square u by dt d theta square plus u is equal to, what is the FR value here? What we go from the gravitational law? I mean, why we are calling this, tell me, square, inverse square law.
gravitational inverse square law formula is gmm by r square. Okay, from that what we have done is f by m. So you are going to get it minus gm by r square. Here force per unit mass, that is we are defining as fr. Okay, so if I substitute this here, the equation number one, what we are going to tell me, and this minus and this minus both will cancel, right? And you're gonna end it with, you're gonna end it with what?
Gm by r square.
G. Okay. Gm by r square.
By
x square, u square, right? Is it clear?
Okay, sir. Okay.
So now what I am trying to say, we know that we always, previously we assumed u is equal to 1 by r, right? When I do, can I make it like this? What I can do, okay, u is equal to 1 by r, u r is equal to 1, okay? U square, if I do square on both sides, u square r square is equal to 1.
Okay.
Sir.
Okay. Okay, sir.
So
okay.
Here, if I substitute that,
gm by r square. Gm
going to tell me
r square into
d
r
square.
D square u by d theta square.
Okay.
Plus u.
Plus u. Equal.
Gm.
So now tell me, gm by u square r square. I have to keep it 1, right?
Substitute the value.
Yes. One. Yes. Gm by h square. That's it, right?
Okay.
So here I'm putting r square u square is equal to 1.
Okay, sir.
So this is our equation now. You should remember this. Make it a box also. So then what I want to do next is, I'm going to take gm is equal to mu. Let gm is equal to mu. Let us make it in terms of mu, because g is a gravitational constant, m is the mass of the sun, so we don't want this term. This is going to be effective mass later. Okay, we're gonna call this effective mass. So if I keep that, this equation going to be, what is going to be, tell me, d square u by dt square plus u is equal to mu by h square. Okay? Is it okay? So if I bring this into other side, this is enough. Man. You can keep it. This is over. Derivation is over. So what is the derivation for this? Tell me. Equation of motion of a particle. With respect to this inverse square law, right? Inverse square law. Is it clear? The last equation you don't need to do it. That it just simply you are making this into inside. Okay, and it doesn't matter. You don't need to write this equation. This is enough. Up to here is okay. If you want to write it, this you can take inside. But it this is enough. This equation is okay. So, any doubts so far? Students, it's a very basic equation. This derivation is very easy. What we have done is, first we consider this equation. Then we wrote an equation for the square, we Newton's inverse square law. F is equal to gmm by r square. From that, what we done is we bring this m into the other side and that is going to be force per unit mass. So we give the name 2. So then we substitute 2 into 1, where you have the FRN. Then that's it. We didn't do much actually. Then we assume this U square R square to 1. Okay? Is it clear? Students?
Sir, I understand, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. So, yeah. Then finally, we're going to go actually. This is a very, very important. First law. Derivation for the first law.
Plus first law.
Please write down ready. Very, very important. Every paper should be one question better. First law, second law, third law.
Kepler.
So write down the heading, derivation of Kepler's first law. Okay. So whatever we got the equation, we'll write it here. So d square, the previous equation. So what we are doing, how we got this equation, tell me. Anybody want to tell? U minus mu by h square plus mu, sorry, u minus mu by h square is equal to 0. How we got this equation? Suppose if I write it like, you know, d square by d theta square minus d square by d square mu by d theta square by h also there. I think this would be. Does anyone point out here how we got this equation? Does anybody? What do you do here? Subtract. Mu by h square on both sides. Subtract the term this on both sides. What I can get to tell me? So this equation we already know that before. D square u by d theta square plus u is equal to mu by h square. So when I subtract this term, what I can do? I have to write it like this. D square by d theta square. Okay. Minus plus u minus mu by h square. This is equal to mu by h square minus mu by h square. So this will cancel and going to be 0. Okay. Then finally, what are you going to get it? D square u by d theta square. Okay. Plus u minus mu by h square equal to 0. But here it's something else, right? I think this is wrong. This shouldn't be like that. This should be like this. So this should be like this. So let us say this is correct equation. Then we go further. When you are doing for the first law, you take this equation. You just start from this equation. Okay. Just copy this equation. And go for the next slide. So what was the equation we got it? D square u by d theta square, right? Plus u minus u by h square equal to zero. Okay. So mu minus, sorry, u minus mu by h square is equal to, you can assume that a cos theta minus theta naught. Okay. Can anyone admit him, Mahesh Poli? So let's, you can say that. So this is the equation what we got it from the previous page. Then here I am assuming that u minus whatever this term is here, I am saying that u minus u by h square equal to a cos theta minus theta naught. Okay. Then what I do here, I can write it u is equal to mu by h square plus a cos theta minus theta naught. Okay, then what I want to do it here, you see, dividing numerator and denominator in RHS by this. So we have to divide and divide whatever the RHS term is, this right side one. So what is going to be telling? In the left side one, what you can write is u is equal to 1 by r beta. Can I write it? U is equal to 1 by r, right? I'm going to write it in the right side. So divide, dividing the numerator and denominator by a. So when I divide this, what happened with the, I have to divide entire term by this. So mu by h square plus a cos theta minus theta naught. Divide, okay, divide, what should I divide? Term h square by mu naught. If divide by h square by mu by, this is the numerator. Numerator will divide by h square by mu. Denominator, what is there, beta? One is there, right? Is it clear? One is there, right? H square by mu. Can anyone understand this? So can anyone tell me yes or no? So whatever this equation is there, that can be divided. See, I wrote it here. Dividing numerator, denominator. So this is your, let us say, this equation is numerator by 1. Okay. So numerator you have to divide it. Denominator also you have to divide by this. In that case, what happened? Tell me. When I divide this, this by this, and this will be multiply. H square by, so this is going to be 1 by r is equal to, okay, this will go and multiply here, this will go and multiply numerator and cancel with the mu by h square, okay, when it go h square by mu beta, and this is going to be 1, okay. Then what happened here? A h square by mu cos theta minus theta naught by h square by mu. Okay. And after, is it clear all of you how I got it here? I did not do anything but a simple term, whatever you got it here, I'm dividing, multiplying by this term. So this is our numerator, I'm dividing by numerator, and denominator, let us say 1 is there, I'm also dividing that. So when I do this like this, beta, 1 by 2 by 3 by 2, what happened? 1 by 2 into 2 by 3. So you have to assume like this, 2, 2 will cancel. Okay, and now what I'm going to say, I'm going to write it this equation 1 plus e cos theta by L. So this entire constant, whatever it is here, I'm saying that, let me not that one. So this equation is, I'm saying that is L value. This is equal to, you can assume L. Okay. No, sorry. L is equal to, you can say, L is equal to H square by mu. L is equal to, so this is going to be L, and E should be equal to this. Whatever it is here is E. Okay. Then now you can write it, if you substitute this, you are going to end up 1 by R is equal to 1 plus E cos theta. You can write it, theta 0 equal to, you can keep it as a 0, cos theta by L. And this is our basic equation of ellipse, depending on the values of eccentricity. Here is what eccentricity, manamu ellipse lo jarugutam intermediate lo. So, E is the eccentricity. If E is less than 1, the path should be ellipse out of E is equal to 1, it is parabola out of E, greater than the hyperbola out of E. Okay? And this is the condition. This is over. First law is over, actually. So, first law is over. Okay? So, how? Let me clarify it again. Let me revise it. Whatever we completed now. Attendance, did they post attendance? No, right?
No, sir.
I'll post it. But is it clear? Tell me wherever you didn't understand. First equation, beta. Let me again recall this. First equation, we got it, this equation from the equation of motion. Okay? You have to remember. First, if they ask this question, how do we do it? If they ask this question, first you have to state the Kepler's first law. Okay? So, all planets revolve around revolve in an elliptical path and are situated in another position. Then, according to the equation of motion, of a particle under central force is given by this. Okay. So after that, what I assumed here, u minus mu by h square is equal to a cos theta. Then I bring this into this side. I got this equation. And where u is 1 by r. 1 by r is equal to mu by h square plus a cos theta. Then what I did here is, I divided this term on both sides. I mean, not both sides. Divided numerator and denominator. This is the denominator and this is the numerator. So what I did is, I divided the numerator by h square by u. Again, denominator also 1 is there. I divided by h square by u. So when I simplify this, this will go and reverse it. Mu by h square, when you bring it to the numerator, right? And when you multiply this, what happens, sir? When you bring it to the numerator, this is going to be h square by, just check it actually. So just check it, you're going to end it with like this. You're going to end it with 1 plus, so that will, this first value is cancelled, and that will be like, I think, No, wait, this will go actually multiply h square by mu beta.
because 1 by this, 1 by this, when I write 1 by this, this will go complete term go into multiply first numerator term. Okay, so h square by mu, so h square by mu, so here h square by mu is there and that will cancel here. You're gonna get 1 plus whatever terms you're gonna get it here,
that is e cos theta by l. Okay, and this equation indicates actually expression for the conic general expression for the conic section in polar quadrant. So when you express all this stuff, when you know e is eccentricity, when e is less than 1, ellipse equal parabola greater hyperbola. Remember that when e is less than 1, what is that? Ellipse. Then e is equal to 1, parabola. Greater than 1, hyperbola. I hope you understand. Right?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? First line is clear, right? Students. Hello? Can anyone say?
Sir, explain here, please.
So I'm going to stop today. So the next class I'm going to...